Today I'm going to talk about using pivot tables, what they are intended to do, which is to let you find useful information from big data. So here on my sheet here, I have data that was downloaded from another program, and I have 5,000 lines of data for 1 month of operation for this firm. Now, the only thing that I have done to this data is I've created a table by going insert and table, and it's put it into a table. Now, what I would like to do is I would like to insert a pivot table from here. Now, we have all these lines of data, and it's very useless when it's the way it is here. But if you use pivot table to quickly manipulate your data, you can get useful information very quickly out of it. So let's go, we're going to go insert, and we're going to go pivot table, and I'm going to select that it goes on a new worksheet, and I'm going to say okay. And so on this new pivot table, I'm only looking for two things. I'm looking for the salesperson. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to select salesperson from my list here, and I'm going to put it down in the rows column. And I'm going to put the amount that they sold, and I'm going to put the amount in the values. So here you go already. This is exactly what you need. You have the salesperson and the amount, and it's done quick. You don't have to do too much fooling around. So let's make these into dollar signs. So we'll go number format, and we'll go currency. And say okay. And there you have your number format. You found out how much each salesperson has sold. Now, let's go back to our sheet here. So that was relatively quick. So let's find out how many sales they're making to each of the customers. Each salesperson has a different set of customers. So let's do another pivot table. So let's go insert and pivot table. And once again, I'm going to put it on another sheet, and I'm going to say okay. And what I'm going to do is in the rows, I'm going to put the account number. And then in the value field, I'm going to put the amount that they sold. And so to filter this, let's put the salesperson there. Okay, so now we see all of the salespeople with all of the customers here. So let's just pick a salesperson, and let's say Dave is the one, and so we say okay. And now we see the sales for Dave, and that's as simple as it gets. So let's analyze this. Go to pivot chart, and I want a line. And so we say okay. We're trying to keep this very simple. And so let's go, we've got Dave here, and so now let's go look at what Jan sold this month for which customers. And you can see quick and easy. I'm one of the guilty parties of creating fancy dashboards, but you know what? The best part about pivot tables is you don't have to spend much time manipulating your data. You can get quick answers out of big data sheets. So there we have our two quick pivot tables that we've done. Let's do Larry, see what he looks like. And there you have. You can see what their sums, who they sold to, quick and easy. This is what pivot tables are supposed to be for. So this is how you do a quick pivot table to display your information from your data. Please subscribe.